All right, now we're good. There's always something with the sound, isn't there? I'm trying to figure out. But yeah, the game isn't registering what's going on. Oh, there's always something. Go ahead, game. I just had this 2 seconds ago. What the hell? Hang on, let me just restart the game. Let's see if I can get it. The controller doesn't want to work. Let's see if I can get it. All right, let's try it again. Okay, now it's going. I don't know. My controller like wasn't registering or something. I don't know why that happens. Anyway, so let me know if I'm good. All right, guys, so this is gonna be Shovel Knight. Sorry for the quick tech difficulties. I'm gonna start a new profile. So I did Shovel Knight, the main game. We went through that, and this is gonna be Plague Knight. So after you beat the game, basically what happens is it unlocks another character, and now I'm gonna be Plague Knight. I've been wanting to do this for a while. How you doing, Chaos Axe? How's it going, Cactus Jesus? That's right. And Josh says that this is so much harder. So I haven't played Plague Knight before. So apparently it's harder. Thanks, Jason. Springwood Slasher said that this is a tough expansion. Alright, I didn't know that this was going to be tough. So this is harder than regular Shovel Knight, guys? Baby says, last time I watched, Mike said ass plague like 7 or 8 times. That sounds like something I would have said. Judge says, it's way different, all new mechanics. So there's some, you know, games I've been trying to catch up on playing. This is one of them. So we're gonna skip ahead here. So just so you guys know, this is the first time I ever played the Plague Knight expansion, but I did play through the Shovel Knight one. And I know that there's another one that I want to also do. All right, let's see. So we have a new jump. So you hold down X, and there's another jump, apparently. It's cool with throwing like his little magic jars or whatever they are, those little bombs. It's a little like Mario 2 in that you have to sort of wait to jump, you know, that extra jump you can do in Mario 2, the American Mario 2. For Shovelry. That's funny. So there's Plague Knight, and there's another one that just got released, right? I'm trying to think of the name of the other one. There's another one that you can do. The Spectre? Is that what it is? Spectre Knight? And, those are bosses that are in the original Shovel Knight game. Plague Knight's a boss. So I'm kind of curious if, so there's health, that's good. I'm kind of curious if they're going to keep on with that. But For right now, let's see if we can even make it through Shovel Knight. Spectre of Torment, yes. Does anybody know if there's plans to do another one after Spectre of Torment? I love collecting that treasure. King Knight is apparently confirmed. Is okay, so that's the yeah, I remember that guy. That's interesting. I wonder what his like how his mechanics are gonna really work. And some people are saying it depends if it does well on the Switch. I'd imagine it probably would do alright, don't you think? It's a good game. How do I pick that up? So let's see, X, Y, B, A. Huh. Anybody know how to pick that up?
You just beat King Knight?
Hey, Eric. Yeah, I know. Oh, I guess it disappeared. Sorry, I was reading the chat. I thought that maybe was an expansion. A health expansion, but I guess that's just regular life. So far, I pretty much like this mechanic. It takes a little time to charge it. I love the look of Plague Doctor Mask. So much mystery. Do I have to go up and around, or is there a... Oh wait, how did I do that? Is there a way to chuck them up? Hang on. I'm trying to figure this out, let's see. Is there a way to chuck them up? And I obviously just did it somehow. I'm not sure. What I did. Is there a way to chuck the things up, or am I like jumping through it? Let me see what you guys have to say. How do you get through this? Plague Knight's head reminds me of that scene in Beetlejuice, and they have weird heads. Yeah, speaking of that, I actually know somebody who actually owns the original prop for that elongated mask in Beetlejuice. Oh, it's just this jump. Alright. Thought maybe you had to throw these little bombs. Excuse me while I get used to it. I haven't done this before. And it's very different to play as Plague Knight than playing as Shovel Knight. Totally different sort of gameplay mechanic going on, which I like it so far. It's really cool how you can do like these double jumps. Alright, so there's another. Oh, you fuck. Alright, I'm gonna have to learn how to do this. Fuck. See, I'm concerned about hitting that fucking bug thing. Why is he not? I thought you could stop in the air and toss your things. Let's see. I gotta learn how to do this. See, like, if I go like this, I can toss them. But maybe not when you're moving, I don't know. Oh, you motherfucker. I almost had it. This is totally like they're trying to teach you how to do shit like this. This is gonna be hard. Oh, fucker. Damn it. I guess I gotta, I'm not sure. I gotta figure it out. I don't get what it is to get him to stop in the air to... See, if you're just like that, he'll... This is hard. How you doing, Ty, Zuni? I don't know how you stop when you're jumping forward to be able to throw these things. See, when I jump straight up, I can toss these like continually, but when you jump out, when you jump out, it does it like, let's say, damn, and then I go too far. What I'm worried about is if I... Alright, I'm just gonna concentrate on killing the guy first and not landing it. So let's just concentrate on that. There we go. Oh, fuck. Almost had it. Alright, so that's what you do. Fuck, I hope there's not a lot of... I hope there's not a lot of this shit. Because this is like... Oh, you mother. Damn. This is a learning curve. There we go. Oh, fuck, fuck. Motherfucker, I almost had it, but then I slipped off. This is hard. This is much harder than... There we go. All right. Oh, that's tough. Wow, this is gonna be hard, huh? Fuck. I'm wishing I had Shovel Knight right now. This is hard to do. This is gonna take some heavy getting used to. Whoa, what the hell is this? Wait a second, I'm not ready for that yet. No! Alright, I guess I'm doing this anyway. I did not expect that to open up into a whole different thing. What are these little green coins for, I wonder? I have no idea what those do. Oh, I have to go get that, too. Dude, you gotta find Mario. What? Alright, that dude just flew by. So what are these green coins all for? I got 20 of them now. Can he not, like, climb on the walls or anything? I feel like he should be able to do that. Maybe that's an ability you get. I feel like he should be able to do that. Wow, okay. I don't know, I'm gonna just say fuck it to that one green coin. Come on, move forward, Mr. Dragon. Let's go. Oh, Spectre Knight climbs on the walls. Okay. Nobody knows what the green coins do? Anybody? You need to give them to somebody for spells, somebody's saying. Okay. Oh god, this is gonna be fun. I'm not even gonna bother doing that, because I have no idea how. You guys should have seen the Alien game I played yesterday, which was the Alien 1990 arcade game. There was a boss that looked like an asshole. You should go back and check out that stream I did if you guys want to see a boss that literally looks like a fucking asshole. And I don't mean like he was an asshole. I mean he looked like an actual asshole. I was pretty amazed by that. It was an amazing asshole. The things you learn when you play arcade games from 1990s. Pretty amazing. Alright, here we go. Is this gonna be the Black Knight? An animal or a human asshole, says Chaos X. Probably an animal. I need to shovel Dragonzord. Summon Dragonzord. So he's saying he's a traitor. I feel like this guy should be easier with Plague Knight, what we'll say. Cause it's like you can do this shit, so it's like, what's this guy even gonna do? Fucking die, that's about it. His head came out of this sphincter. Yeah, that was Alien for the arcade game. Alright, I'm curious how similar this is going to be to actual Shovel Knight. So far it looks like it's going to be pretty similar. Oh shit, am I getting kicked out? Oh, I thought it was because I blew him up. He, like, literally just doesn't want me to come in. Shit. What? Oh, everybody's scared of me. Huh. Okay. Mike, you have a PhD in assholes. That's true, I do. Thanks, I'm glad you noticed. Oh yeah. Fuck waiting a week for a key. She's gonna open. Look at this fucking shit. Potionatorium. Shop? Yeah, let's shop. Wall climbing flames. That sounds pretty awesome. What's this? I don't have enough for that. Anyway, all this sounds good. I'm gonna try to get this. Oh, what's this? Burst? Float slowly to the ground. That sounds like it's probably good. I'm gonna get that. Alright, I don't know. I'm not sure exactly how that's gonna work, but I'm getting it. Oh, damn it. Look at all these fucking people. I'm gonna have to come back and talk to all of them, but we're gonna keep going for now. How did you guys choose Cinemassacre for the website? It says NES Man 1985. That's James' website that he made. I don't get what the deal is with these things. Like, how do you pick those up? I guess that's just I have full life, so I can't get it. Is that what that means? Cinemassacre is just James' website that he made, like, in, like, 1999 or something, and he's had it since then. It's just a name he came up for his company brand. Before that, it was called Cinematica, I think, and he had it called Cinemassacre, which is, like, it's supposed to be, like, massacring cinema. It's like taking your, you know, taking what traditional Hollywood would do and massacring the idea of it, changing it, doing something new. That's what Cinemassacre means. And, you know, Angry Video Game Nerd is just one thing that, you know, James came up with. He had made 100 or so movies, probably more than that, actually, before Angry Video Game Nerd existed. So Cinemassacre was all about, let me just, like, jump up like this. Cinemassacre is all about just, massacring the Hollywood formula, I guess you could say. And the website is just, you know, the name of the film company. And Angry Video Game Nerd is one show that Cinemassacre produces. Of many. We've done Monster Madness and tons of different web shows. So I hope that answers that question. I remember when Angry Video Game Nerd first started, or early on at least, back in like 2006, I remember somebody was like, who are these Cinemassacre people trying to take over Angry Video Game Nerd? It's like, well, it's actually James. So I guess James is trying to take over himself. I think people were concerned that there was some company that was trying to come down on us or something. But yeah, that's just James, company that I work for and have for 11 years. Blow his head right the fuck off. What are you gonna do? Sell the two knight. Blow you the fuck up. Man, these guys are strong, huh? Alright, let's see if I can get up here. Oh, did I have to fucking bounce off him? That was stupid, I should have did that. I probably had to do that. So actually, let's double check and see if... Is there any way I can get up there? Oh, there we go. Thought so. And those things are right out of Zelda 2 as well. I've considered it chaos, but I don't think so. Oh wait, I can't blow this up? Oh, you would think that that would be something to blow up. Why can I not get up here? There we go. Alright, this is gonna be tough shit. Alright. Okay, I didn't think I was gonna get the same weapons that you get in Shovel Knight. That's pretty cool. I'm super concerned about hitting these spikes. Let me actually switch to that. Oh wait, this menu is like totally different, huh? Oh, trade them. Oh, can you not actually? Maybe you can't use it. That's interesting. Fuck. Oh, okay. That was concerning for a second. Yo, Mike, what is this game about, really? I don't fucking know. it's cool. I like it because it's got a good gameplay. What it's about, I don't know. In the first one, you're like a knight and you rescue, Shield Knight. You're like this knight with a shovel and you rescue a knight that has a shield. I don't know. This one, one of the enemies is this guy, Plague Knight, And there's like, I don't know, 8 different enemies in the original game, something like that. I don't know exactly how many. And he's one of them. And so after you beat the game, you can play through it with one of the bosses. That's basically the deal. I have no idea how I would get over there. That's going to be... I feel like you probably need an item to do that. If there is a way to do that, I'm not going to risk it at the moment. Oh shit. I really thought that was gonna be food. Why wouldn't I? It was on a silver platter. Sweet. So many throwbacks to DuckTales. Those knights remind me of the knights with that their heads come off in the DuckTales NES game. And obviously, you know, with the pogo jumping with Shovel Knight. I thought maybe that would respawn. I wonder if I can actually make it. Let's see if I can make it. Probably shouldn't have. Oh, wow. A better jumper than I thought. I feel like Plague Knight's more powerful than Shovel Knight with these bombs. I mean, pretty awesome. I have to say, I'm really liking this. Whoever, you know, the team that developed this game, they really came up with a fun game. Like, this is what you want, really. Oh, now you see that? See, no. Okay, so I don't have fucking full health now. And, alright, I'm pausing it. How do I get those? Because, see, I don't have full health. I thought what was going on before was that I had full health, so it wasn't giving it to me. But now, so I don't have, you know, I only have half health, so apparently that's health. So how do I fucking get those? I tried, like, throwing. Oh, you know what? Maybe I use. Let me try this. Oh, no, that doesn't work. Yeah, shit, what do I do? How do I get that? Oh, I'm maxed out? Hang on. Okay, let's see. Oh, they were doing it like that? I see. Okay. See, I didn't know, because that's totally different than how Shovel Knight works. So, I'm learning. Really? Who do I fucking... Oh, you gotta be really high up, alright. There we go. Food! Oh god, don't break that. I have to be careful about that, too. Fucking assholes. This game is super fun.
Boom!
So good.
Yeah, that's true, Cactus. That is my favorite beer.
Haven't had one in a long time. Fuck. How far back is that gonna set me? Alright, we're getting to the end of this first one. That's good. Really wasn't much of a reason to come in here, huh? Was that it? That seems pretty anticlimactic. God, this is gonna get me killed. I see it coming already. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. I should have done the bigger jump. Those jumps are nerve-wracking to do because they're fucking slippery. Hey, thanks, Popo. Popo Popo. That's quite the name. See, like that. Alright. I guess this is just gonna stay now? No. No, it's not. There we go. That's what I wanted to do. So these are containers that you can use later. That's what I didn't understand. Very different than Shovel Knight. Alright, here we go. Fuck you. It's so satisfying to kill things in this game. Super satisfying gameplay. I really, really enjoy it. Oh, so this is the guy, this is King Knight, and he's the one that the next game, well, the one after, there's a Spectre Knight who apparently can climb on walls. And King Knight, I don't know what he'll be able to do. But we'll see. Guess we'll find out. Bad start. Boom. The king is gonna tax that ass. That's That's what he does. That's going to be his ability. He's going to tax. His special tax ability. Sometimes it's really fucking annoying when you lose your money. Yeah. Well, there's things that you can get to... King Knight's essence is ours, and I discovered that his crown isn't real gold. Ooh. He's a fucking sham. I knew it. Pretender, indeed. Fuck it, let's take it. A wave of fire in both directions. And actually, I can still afford this, so let's get it. Alright. Nice. So that was cool. Oh, let's go fuck him up. Oh, it's gonna be a level. No! Fuck. Oh my god, I'm getting fucked up so hard by this flying dragon thing. Sometimes you feel like you should just have that shovel. There should be versus Shovel Knight where you can choose Shovel, Spectre, or Plague. That would be cool. Thanks, Paul. Man, these things are tough. No! Ha! Thanks, Josh. Good luck with Propeller Knight stage. It's hard. Oh, boy. Is that the one that's coming up? First of all, I want to try to get through this part. I'm having a little hard time with. And I love the Mario 3-esque maps thing they're doing. Like, I hate that I can't. Oh my god. I need to find an attack that'll, like... Because when that guy's hiding down there, see, Shovel Knight would be able to fuck him up easy. Just pogo jump on his ass. There we go. No! Damn it. You guys are right. This is gonna be tougher. You shit. Oh, I hate the waiting between the rounds. Just get me back there. There. Fuck away from these things. No, you little shits! It's these fucking flying fuckers. And they take several hits to hit, too. They're the things that are fucking me up. You have to be very precise about, Mike, what is your favorite 8-bit game and your favorite 16-bit game? There's so many, Cody. But, you know, gone on record many times to say Zelda. I really do love Zelda. It's so much fun. If I can just fucking kill this motherfucker. There we go. Oh, did he fucking respawn? Fuck you. Oh. There. I don't know why that was so difficult. So, I don't, it's harder to pick 16-bit. You know, obviously I love, like, Link to the Past. But, you know, I just played through Contra Hardcore, and that was fucking awesome, I have to say, for, you know, 16-bit Sega Genesis game. I really love Toe Jam and Earl for Sega Genesis. Super Castlevania is great. F-Zero. You know, Super Metroid. There's so many. It's really hard to pick a favorite when there's so many great games that are available out there to play. But, I don't know, we played a lot of games. We play games every week. Oh god, this is gonna be a shit show. So I guess they're saying you don't need those anymore. Because now I have that jump. They're like the Medusa heads. What was like the Medusa heads? Oh, I know what you're saying. Those fucking green flying motherfuckers. Yeah, they were fucking assholes. These frogs are assholes too. I think the theme of this stream so far has been me talking about assholes. That's fine. That's what I'm good at. Talking about assholes. Oh my god. Alright, boom. God forbid there's any food. Guess I don't really need that much right now anyway. But we're gonna go up here and collect the treasure. We're gonna get the treasure. Maybe we're gonna get the treasure. There we go. So you gotta collect it, because when you go back to the towns, you need to buy shit. So what's the floaty thing that I bought? Let's see. I thought they said, like, you hit down or something. Trying to see what is this something you have to actually turn on? Let's see. Should we try like this shit? I don't know. Let's try these different things. Okay, well, that's pretty cool. I wonder if those are unlimited or if, like, I have to watch how I use them. Like, do those take up magic? Doesn't seem like it does. Maybe I'll leave that on for now. I kind of, this is slower though. I kind of miss my other thing. Like, it's cool, but it's not fast, and it's also not blowing that up. Which, you know what, I'm gonna. Oops. Was that the one? No. I guess it wasn't the first one. Let's see. Yeah, that's it. Okay. had the wrong one on. So, just so I know, black powder. That's like the quicker one. Standard fuse blows up after a few moments. Bounce along the ground before exploding. I don't know, I'm just gonna stick with this. I like it. Give me that. Wait, is that an extra? Is that a way to go with it? Let's say. Yeah, it is. How about that? Let's fuck up these frogs, too. I don't know what. I'm just gonna go back. I don't think I need to be fighting these guys. It's not like there's, oh no, there's the green thing. I gotta get that. All right. It's very interesting how he jumps and then kind of jumps again and jumps a third time when he's like, he gets to a platform and then he can kind of climb up. So it's like you get a double jump and then like a climb up to. This is where I'm gonna get pissed because I hate these levels. Any level that has like just total darkness like that, I've never been a fan of. And I got through it with Shovel Knight, but I didn't enjoy it. It was the only part of the game I didn't enjoy, I have to say. And DuckTales had a level like this too, but I will say they did it a little better in DuckTales because I'll tell you why. Like, you see in this game, like, see, okay, right here, like, I can see my silhouette in the background. That I'm fine with, but when you're standing, like, right here, you can't fucking see anything, so you have no idea where you are. That I don't like when it... Can you really blame me? Like, I don't like absolute pitch black where I can't see where my character is. That's one thing that I don't care for. That's not my favorite thing in the world. Basically. Oh fuck, I just fucked that up. Oh man, I needed to jump. Ninja Gaiden 2 had one as well. Oh yeah. Yeah, not something I enjoy. Like, I can get through it, I can do it, but I don't like it. That's all I'm saying. Oh. Fuck. So I've been watching horror movies with my girlfriend, and I'm getting her to be quite the horror expert. All we pretty much do is watch horror movies, and I thank you guys for some of the suggestions. I feel like I've watched like every fucking horror movie practically that's ever existed at this point, because, you know, I helped James edit Monster Madness for 10 years, and I pretty much the only genre of shit that I watch is horror for the most part. And I don't, like, this part sucks. I'm just getting out of here. I don't even want to deal with that. But I'm always interested in... Oh God, why do I have such a hard time with this? I'm always interested in watching horror movies that I haven't seen. And people say, oh, well, have you seen The Babadook? And have you seen It Follows and stuff? And yes, I've seen those. So you gotta have this guy lower the platform. It's the weight of the thing. But basically, my point is, My point is the cough. My point is, I always appreciate the suggestions for horror movies. And let me just jump to my death. I have seen The Human Centipede, Luke Leopard, and actually we did a review on it for Monster Madness 9. That was one that I was actually part of. And I also saw Human Centipede 2, which is a really fucked up movie. One of the most fucked up movies that I've ever seen, actually. Those movies are just fucked up. But, yeah, and I've seen, I saw Audition, and I actually liked Audition quite a bit. Audition's, you know, it's a crazy one, but I thought it was entertaining. It had a story to it, you know? Fuck. And it was definitely horrific, so. Yeah, I've seen Vampire, 1932. Sometimes, so some people are asking about subtitle movies. Sometimes I like to watch movies with some subtitles, but I have to be in the mood for it. Like, I saw the Japanese Godzilla, the recent one, and I thought it was great, actually. I really enjoyed it. Even though the whole movie was in subtitle. But I have to be, like I said, I have to be in the mood for it. So most of the time, I would rather just watch a movie that I can, you know, that I can just not have to read the whole thing. Because it is, like, a little bit of extra effort. I'll do that sometimes, but most of the times I'm looking for a movie that I can just watch. So I gotta get this over here. Jump. Yeah, I've seen VHS Intimidation. And I've seen Wreck, like Record. Shit. Boy, there's creatures coming out of Godzilla's tail at the end of Shin Godzilla. Creatures coming out of his tail. Oh, yeah, yeah. That's a good question. Who said that? Amontis? Yeah, I didn't know what that was either. I thought maybe that was them trying to be like, okay, well, Godzilla's dead, but he's having babies or something, and, you know, this is going to continue. So it's like they won the fight for now, but they haven't won overall. I kind of thought that that's what they might have been going for there. But, you know, that's just an idea. That might not be right at all. That's what I took out of it, though. What character am I playing as? It says T-Run Laws. This is Plague Knight, who's one of the bosses from Shovel Knight. And so the way it works is, I actually didn't know how it worked. I actually thought it was a whole nother game that you had to buy, but you don't. Basically, you just get Shovel Knight, and then after you beat Shovel Knight, it unlocks Plague Knight, and then you can play through the whole game as Plague Knight. And then I guess if you beat the whole game as Plague Knight, you can play through the game as Spectre Knight. And then apparently King Knight is coming, but not I suck so much at getting up like that. Apparently King Knight is on the way. That's what I've been told. I don't know how true it is. But that would be cool. I'm curious if they're gonna actually try to do all of the all the bosses into its own game. That would be crazy if they actually did them all. I feel like they probably won't get to all of them, but it's nice that, you know, they're adding all this stuff to it. I think it's pretty awesome that you can continue the game after you've beaten it, because it is the kind of game that I think it's so good that you want to just keep playing it, and it's great that you can with all these additions. So I'm really a fan of it. It's really good. I feel like I just did a review for the fucking game. Come on, guys. This is only a live stream. It's not a review. Cut me a break. I'm just fucking around here. Get up there. Get up there. Get up there. Name the AVGN video that I just quoted. See who can get it first. I'll do it again. Get up there. Get up there. Who knows it? Who's the first to answer that? Let's see who the first person that can get that is. Gary Davis says, Turtles, you are right. We got some good fans in the chat. Connor got it, Man got it, New Wave Junkie got it. Very good, guys. Fuck, I remember playing that game with James back when we did that video. And, I mean, you guys have seen me play that game. I probably talked about that enough. You'll watch my TMNT live stream. I'm sure I talked about all that. Fuck! See, like this. Like that is a good example. Like, I literally just couldn't see. I guess I just have to have a little more patience with that. But I couldn't see what I was fucking doing. That's why I don't like it. It's like, it slows you down. My only complaint with the game. And I can say that because oh shit. See? And I didn't know that was coming. Because I played through all of Shovel Knight. I would say that's the only thing I don't like is those dark stages. Not a fan. Maybe some people do like it though, so I mean, I don't know. It's just not my thing. Clown House? No, I haven't seen Clown House. Oh, you motherfucking... See, I'm getting impatient. I can't wait to get through this stage, because I think the only level in... I think the only stage in this game that's like this is this area, so it'll be a good thing to get through. I don't know, am I alone with this? What do you guys think of stages like this? Like, am I crazy that I don't like the dark stages like this? Is it just me? Maybe it's just me. I'm curious to see other people's opinions on the matter. Because it's just not my favorite. Michael Jones says they suck. Enthusiastic says always hated them. Travesty says these levels suck. Hendrick Anderson says a bit annoying. Only other part on the last level is like this, and yeah, this kind of dark stages sucks. DuckTales did it better along with Donkey Kong. Thank you, Cody. Somebody else said watching is okay, but playing no. Yeah, you can watch me struggle and be annoyed by it, right? That's fine. You're fine with that. You're fine watching me not enjoy it. That's funny. Yeah, we'll watch you do it all day long, Mike. That's fine. You enjoy that. Fuck! See, it's like, it's a fucking guessing game with these platforms. Oh. At least with this one, oh shit. At least with this one, that you guys are on my side. I guess I can blow that up too, huh? And the other thing is, it stays light for such a small amount of time. If it stayed light like an extra split second or something, maybe I would have less of a problem with it, but it's so brief. This is one thing that DuckTales did it better. Gotta say. DuckTales did it better. Alright. Please be the thing. Oh my god, thank god. I think we're through that. You can hear, stop hearing me complain about it as much. I think they do it during the boss fight, but at least it's the level part of it's over. Spectre Knight. So this is the guy that the next game in the series is based off of. So it's Plague Knight, then Spectre Knight, and then after that is Damn it. This is gonna be tough. Oh, you fucker. This is probably gonna take me a couple tries. That was a little bit better, though. A little bit. Damn it. Yeah. And it's gonna go dark soon, too, so. He's gonna tell me the whole story again that I don't wanna hear. I've not mastered these controls yet at all with this guy. Oh, fuck. Damn. These corners. Man, I feel like I suck at this so badly. Oh my god. Thanks, Cody. Oh, did better the first time I fucking went in here. Come on with the cinematics shit. Just fucking start. I get really impatient with reloading. Damn it. Yeah, and here it goes. Here's where it's gonna get shitty. Here's where I can't see fucking shit. Like, I can't fucking see anything. It drives me crazy. Fuck this now. Like... I can't stand this. I'm gonna fucking get killed because I can't fucking see. There, did I fucking do it? Am I dead at the same time? Oh, it's great to do the second half of a battle in fucking pitch black. I love that. Thank God that's over. Oh, I do not like that fight. Alright, I'm glad that that's over. The painful part is over with. See, the game's so fun other than that fucking level. Text, endless text. Alright, let's get this. Boom. Thanks, Luke. Thanks, Chaos. Oh, we gotta fish him up. Hey, fuck you. Oh, fuck. Huh. Need something else to do that. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if I have what needs to be done there. That's too bad. You're loving Spectre Knight? That's cool. I gotta... When did Spectre Knight come out? It came out not too long ago, right? Let's do this place. Bombs away. I don't know why I had to do that. I felt like I had to do that. I really like the music on the stage too. Memorable. Bum bum bum. Bum bum bum. These games are so fucking good. Why are they so good? You know why they're good? Because they emulate fucking good NES games like DuckTales and Zelda 2. That's why it's fucking good. And also, it's got a very dark theme to it. Like, the theme isn't fucking stupid. You know, you're fucking Plague Knight. That's awesome. Oh, you shit. You thought it was Plague Doctor? Well, the character is Plague Knight, I believe, right? It's not Plague Doctor. But yeah, the real life thing is Plague Doctor. It's so satisfying to blow shit up. They got hit detection down really fucking well. Like, it's actually really satisfying, the way it should be. I don't like these fucking enemies up top. Boom. This is fucking Mario Brothers. Super Mario Bros. It's the Mario Brothers, and Plumbin's the game. It's not like the others who get all the fame. I know I kinda got that, but whatever. What's over here? A little platform that I need to go to. Oh god. I didn't know Plague Knight could fucking fly like that. Bum 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 bum. See, this is a game, a modern game that actually has a fucking tune to it. Memorable music. God forbid we have that in 2017. This is one shining example. I don't know, I guess I just have a certain way I like my games. And this is a team that got it right. Should I jump down there? Fuck. Let's do it. Okay. Wasn't sure. Xbox has the Battletoads, yeah. We did a video on the Battletoads thing. Look up Talk About Games Battletoads and you'll find our Shovel Knight Battletoads video. Oh, this is gonna be bad. Never mind, I did it. I thought that was gonna be a problem. Okay, I have to go underneath, huh? Shit, man. Okay. Fuck! Huh. This looks hard. I have an idea how to do it, though. Shit. No, fuck. I just hit the wrong fucking thing to get out of this. What is it? Oh. Okay. Hopefully all those coins are gonna come in handy later. Hope. Cauldron spider. We learned that last time. Those are awesome. Cool enemies. Bum bum bum. It's so good. It's so good. Remind me of the fucking mice from Mousetrap board game. Who's that Pokemon that looks like Gengar? Don't know why they make these nostalgia games look like console rather than arcade, says Paul Henderson. That's an interesting comment. Probably because we're going to be playing these games sitting at home the way we did, where an arcade game, you would go out to the arcade. So they're trying to replicate, you know, playing consoles at home. Since I'm not in an arcade right now playing this, you know? So, maybe they're trying to go for that console nostalgia. I don't know, I'm just trying to come up with an explanation to your question. But I get what you're saying, though. Why not have the graphics look a little more arcadey? And I do love arcade games. And I do arcade game live streams, too. If you guys are into old 80s arcade games and early 90s arcade games, I implore you to follow my arcade game playlist on Cinemassacre Plays, because that's a long ongoing thing I'm going to be doing. Every once in a while I play an old arcade game, because I feel like there's not a lot of people that do that. Most people that stream are playing, like, I don't know, fucking Call of Duty or fucking something. You know, but I like to, or no, I mean, there's a lot of people that will play something like this. They'll play, like, retro style games, but I actually, like, how many people are actually streaming old arcade games, you know? So I feel like people that like, you know, if you like old arcade games, definitely follow that, because I think it's just a little bit of a niche thing that I'm doing. Heavy Barrel Arcade. That's a good suggestion. Thank you, Matt Smith. But yeah, that's another thing, you know. Right now I'm kind of going through modern games that are retro themed, kind of like this one, it seems. But I do want to play, like, modern games. Like, for example, a game I consider, like, modern is, like, Dark Souls. Fuck, I just fucked myself up. But you know what I mean. Where this is like a retro-themed, modern game. I mean, I want to play everything. I want to play actual, old... Oh my god, can I get up here? I want to play actual old games. Retro games. I want to play retro-modern. I have such a trouble getting up like that. Retro, retro-modern, and modern-modern. Let's say it that way. I want to do them all. And the thing I've been lacking a bit is the modern-modern. I do some of that with Ryan. We do talk about games. And actually, he's been playing Mass Effect Andromeda. So definitely go check that out if you guys are interested in Mass Effect. So he's been working on that. One modern is that I was doing was obviously Zelda, Breath of the Wild. But that's an interesting modern because. Because it's not entirely, because it's based off a franchise that I've been playing since the 80s. So in a way, that's still a little retro to me, even though it's a completely modern game. You know what I mean? I want to play more modern games that were created in modern times. Completely. Like, you know? That's what I need to do more of. But I played Happy Room. And I really like that, and that's a modern game. This is gonna be a bitch. Don't wanna fucking... Okay. Final Fantasy 15. Well, again, that's I think Ryan's actually doing that, or he's gonna be doing it, or something. He was mentioning that to me, but the other thing is truly modern stuff is a lot of those games are really fucking long. Like Final Fantasy 15. How many hours? There's a good question for you. How many hours would I have to put into Final Fantasy 15 if I started streaming that? You know, it's not like this where I could probably do it in 2 or 3 live streams. Sometimes I don't like... See, that even happened to me with Zelda. I was playing that, and it was like, I did... How many fucking live streams did I do of Zelda? Like 20 or something? 17 live streams of Zelda? It's like, they just go on and on and on. And I love it, and Zelda's fucking awesome, but it just goes on and on and on and on. And that's good for me to, like, play on my own. But I don't know. Like, by the time I get to fucking Breath of the Wild part 980, it's kind of like, all right... It's enough Breath of the Wild. Like, it's an amazing game, but like, how long can it fucking go on for? You know what I mean? James says at least 40 hours. Final Fantasy 15 is 15 hours. No, he says Final Fantasy 15 is 50 plus hours at least, says Connor. And that's my exact point. That there's a modern game, and that's why I don't do a lot of that stuff, because they're so fucking long. Like, and I like to beat games, and I don't know if I'm gonna fucking spend 50 hours on live streams to fucking beat a game. Like, it just goes on and on. Like, and Zelda's a franchise that I fucking love. It's like my favorite franchise, but even that is like, I don't wanna do 800 fucking live streams of fucking Breath of the Wild. Just don't wanna do it. You know, I did Zelda 2 on live stream. I think I was able to beat it in 2 live streams. You know, and that was good. I didn't get, like, tired of it or anything. Alright, Plague Knight. Ooh, Shovel Knight. Shovel Knight, show yourself, Plague Knight. Your trickery will not stop me. That's what the guy in the beginning of the stage was warning me about. So we're gonna have to fight Shovel Knight. Which makes sense. I'm gonna get killed immediately here because I have no energy right now. But we'll do it. Desert bus speedrun. Is that what you guys really want to say? Final Fantasy 15 part 46. Haha, 2 watching, says Springwood Slasher. Exactly. Exactly. That's why I like to switch it up. And also, here's the other thing about doing that is, so some people would love me to do, like, you know, just go through a 50-hour game and see that. I know that there's some people that would like that, but what, like, for example, for Breath of the Wild, you know, there are some people that are not interested in Breath of the Wild. They don't care. They don't want to play it. And for those people, if I did 50 fucking live streams, it's like, then I'm totally losing those people because they just, you know, they're like done. They're like, all right, 50 live streams of Breath of the Wild. Well, I don't care because I'm not interested in that game. So it's like, let me try to think about, you know, how everybody feels. This is not going well, and I don't have any fucking... Wow, this is gonna be tough. I think when I beat Plague Knight with Shovel Knight, I had the, what's it called? The Phase Locket, which I don't even know if you can get that with Plague Knight. And he's just throwing out all his... Oh, now he like went crazy on me. He's like, oh, I don't like that. Man, he's fucking strong too, huh? Oh, and he's got the fucking phase locket. Look at my life. This is not going well. Shit. There we go. I didn't think I was beating him that quickly. I thought I was going to have to do that several more times. Wow. Okay. Plague Knight beats Shovel Knight. Give me the orb. Give me your fucking Oh, what's he doing? What's he doing? Oh, shit. Was I supposed to be, like, paying attention there? Fuck. Did I just die? Or was that, like, part of it? Wait, what's happening now? I'm like Shovel Knight. Oh, okay. I guess that was supposed to happen. Freaked me out for a second. I thought I was like looking at the chat for a minute and then I totally missed whatever the fuck it said, but I guess it's fine. Shovel Knight. Yeah, let's leave. Oh, you can research shit too, huh? That's interesting. But let's go up here. Because I'm so good at jumping up like this. Not. Yeah, I definitely want to do that. And also, what else can I do? Only 100 now? Oh, I can't carry anymore. Okay. Wait, what does this do again? Magic upgrade. Increase your magic bar. Yeah, I definitely want that. Good. Who's this guy? What do you have to say? Minion. I picked up your special delivery. Want to take a look? And settle the bill? Bait bomb. Well, I don't have the money for that now. Sorry, dude. No, dude. Get away from me. And how about this horse fucking asshole? Get up, stop. How about horse asshole? Percy, the horse asshole. Ah, Plague Knight, my good friend. No, sir. I just don't like it. My good friend, a moment of your time. How can I help you, Percy? I've run out of paper and I can't fit anymore. Ballistic formula on my hoof. I'm in desperate need. Do you need glue as well? Wow. Alright, so there's that, and what about this guy? Alright. All kinds of shit to do, and interesting characters. But, alright, how long have I been streaming for? I did a few levels here. Hour and a half. PAX was pretty cool, Che. I got to see the Nintendo booth and talk to some people from Nintendo. And I got to go to a cool YouTube party, which was really awesome. And I saw a really cool Transformers game I didn't get a chance to play it. All the lines were really long. I will say that about PAX is like, you better be prepared to wait on lines. But let's fight this guy. Not a good start here. Damn. Thought if I got higher up, it wouldn't really help me, but. Should have used some life, but we'll do it. Rasper says, I would like to go to PAX Prime. Oh boy. That's why you like the smaller cons, Monster Squad? Yeah. Well, the smaller cons, I mean, they're both good for different reasons, basically. Like, if you want to go and try out, you know, new games that are coming out, PAX is good for that. Like, if you want to go play whatever the new, you know, PS4, Xbox games, Nintendo games, you get a chance to play some of them early. Like, they had ARMS there, if you wanted to wait in the line to try it. But, which I actually didn't, because the line was so fucking long, so I actually did not get a chance to play ARMS. But it's like, I'll get a chance to play it anyway, you know, eventually, so. And, like, I can play Mike Tyson's Punch-Out whenever I want, so. I don't know if I'd really cared enough to wait in a fucking 2-hour line to play ARMS. But, yeah, as far as smaller conventions, I like smaller. Fuck, I was just about to use the magic, too. Just hit it right after he hit me. As far as smaller conventions, I like smaller cons because I like to go to cons really for two main reasons. And those reasons are, I like to play arcade games. You know, when retro cons have old arcade games, because a lot of times, you know, it's hard to get to play old 80s and 90s actual coin-op machines these days. And cons are a good place where you can do that kind of thing. So that's one thing I really like to do. And the other thing is to buy games and buy retro games. So the conventions need to have a good selection of games to purchase. And I'm not doing nearly as well this time. But I'll use... See, I feel like I wonder if I used it here, if it would waste it, or if I get it back after I die, and that I don't know. So I'm gonna not use it now since I'm not doing well. Or you know what? Fuck it, I can beat this. Maybe I can beat it. There we go. All right. But yeah, basically retro cons. I like to go to retro game conventions to get games, basically. And those are the two main reasons I go to game conventions. So a good one to do that at, if you guys are in the Philadelphia area, or the tri-state area at least, is Too Many Games. It's over the summer, and they have really good selection of retro games, and they have arcade games. So that's one that I always go to. Thoughts on Cuphead? I want to play it when it comes out. This is actually PC. I got it on Steam. Blaine Fishlock. You have a Mario icon with a weird face. most of the ones you go to are horror related. Well, that makes sense, that because your name is Monster Squad, Monster Squad. And Monster Squad is a movie that I actually want to show my girlfriend, which I like a lot. But I'm trying to show her the original Universal movies before I do that, because it's good to have, you know. We watched a few of them, though. We watched Bride of Frankenstein, and we watched the first Frankenstein movie. Gimme, gimme, gimme. So this game's awesome. I really like it. It's definitely a little bit something to get used to the controls. If you played the first Shovel Knight game, it's quite a bit different. And there's a bit of a learning curve with it, I found. But it's really cool. It's really fun. And it's really satisfying to blow things up with the Plague Knight. So, all right, guys. I'm going to actually get going for now. And we will continue Shovel Knight Plague of Shadows sometime soon. So, thanks for watching, guys. Oh, and one other piece of news. Very shortly, there will be a new Angry Video Game Nerd episode. So, that will be coming. All right, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. And give me some suggestions for horror movies and games to play. You can message me on Twitter, Mike_Matei on Twitter. And Mike@cinemassacre.com if you want to email me. Thanks for watching, guys.